Hey, welcome to Game 6 of Reading Rocket Patriot Football. The Rockets are undefeated this year. Last time we were up in Methuen, Joe, it was a playoff game last year where the B team really handled this Methuen team. Out there we have captains Troy Pollock, Danny Damari, Dom DiCrescenzo, and Lucas Lorenza. I got to do a correction from last week, Joe. Lukey Lorenza gave me a ton of grief because I missed a tackle that he made. Yeah, so he gave it to me, and I said I got to...
Did he tackle you?
Yeah, he threatened to actually tackle me after and say, this is what I did. He also wants to make it perfectly clear that even though I say Dom, every time I talk about Dom, that he's like one of the biggest dudes on the team, he wanted to make it perfectly clear that he's actually the biggest dude in the team. So there you go, number 24, Lucas Lorenza getting his props. This week, Joe, it is absolutely beautiful out here, isn't it?
A little different than last week.
I got a little bit of my Barry White voice going because I just spent 24 hours straight in your old hometown of Manhattan.
You need that. It's part of... part of growing up, Tim.
It was outstanding, Joe. I tell you, I actually drove through the neighborhoods where you used to live, and I mean drove as fast as I could.
Yeah.
I looked around and go, oh, my gosh, these are the mean streets of not exactly Howard Street in Reading, is it, Joe?
No.
Well, listen.
A little busier.
Another correction from last week. There's a little misunderstanding. We were talking about Yard Dog Gus. Your dog is named Gus, and unfortunately, the Pollock family lost their dog named Gus, and he was a beautiful German Shepherd. So, even though we're insensitive most weeks, not when it comes to that.
I know Gus was a favorite of the boys on the field. He'd come to practice.
He was awesome. He'd run right in the pool. Jump right in the pool, and all he wanted to do is have a stick in his mouth, which is very much how I feel right now. I'm talking like I have a stick in my mouth. The Reading Rockets are coming up right now. It's absolutely gorgeous up here in Methuen. Next 2 weeks are going to be at home, Joe. It'll be nice. But the Rockets look to stay unbeaten as we go forward here. All right, the Rockets set to kick off here. Number 44, Stevie Needham, who took over the duties last week, did a nice job. It's a nice kick to start there. Oh, that's a live ball right there. Oh, it looks like the Rockets might have hopped on it. Who's over there? Troy Pollock. It hits the Methuen player in the legs, bounces, and Pollock does a great job just to jump on it before it goes out of bounds. And this is what we're talking about here. This is exactly what Methuen didn't want to do. And the Rockets get the ball back immediately on the kickoff. Bounces off his legs. They're going to take over first and 10 from the Methuen 40. All right, hey, great to have number 23, Lucas Fleming, back. And we get the ground and pound backfield, Fleming and DiCrescenzo. It's right to Dom. He follows Lucas. He takes it for about 3 or 4 yards. Dom DiCrescenzo. I'm trying to call him Dom this week after calling him Dommy for the last 6 weeks. Yeah, I have a buddy named Dommy, so I just revert back to that. But nice start. Great to have Lucas back. He's a big, big player on this team. And the Rockets like to start with this ground and pound with two big dudes in the backfield. Try to run it early. And it's going to be 2nd and 6 upcoming. Looks like Foxy split right. At this time, it's Lucas. Nice job. They're wrapping him up, so he gets about 2 yards here. We're going to be 3rd and 5 upcoming. On 3rd and 5, Coach Pollock sends in Troy and Damari, the sort of second lineup on offense for them. Maybe see him put the ball in the air today. Oh, it's a pitch out to Danny. Danny cuts left and right, but he gets, he's still on his feet. Wow, there's a flag on the play, too. Could be holding on Redding, but he took a big lick from the side. He was very close to the first down, but it might be going against the Rockets here, and it is. So it's going to be 3rd and now make it 15 upcoming. And now you may see Troy throwing right here. All right, it's 3rd and 15 here. Whole new offensive line subbed in for the Rockets. It's a weird wind out here, Joe. It's coming right at us, so Troy's going to be looking to throw here. The only guy in the backfield. He steps up. He stays on his feet. He's getting cutting back, but he gets tackled. And it's going to be 4th down here in about, say, 9. You know what? You may see him go for it here inside the 40. I think you do, too. All right, here we go. It's 4th and call it 10. Rockets are going to go for it in Methuen territory. Only guy in the backfield. Look for him to throw. He goes back. He throws it underneath, and that's Damari. He cuts back. Oh, he goes back the other way, and he's got room. Beautiful play by Damari. And he may get in. This gets pulled out. Wow. He looks left. He cuts back in. And Damari turns nothing into something for the first down. Gets it inside the 10-yard line. So beautiful pass and catch from Pollock to Damari. And we got 1st and goal upcoming. first and goal here for the Rockets after the great pitch and catch, fourth down conversion, Pollock to Damari. It's a low snap. He gets underneath. He throws a little bit high. Damari cutting across the middle there. I think Troy had to make a quick move there on him very quickly. A couple of big boys on that line from Methuen. And we're used to seeing that this year. Those guys from Westford last week were all big dudes on the line too. So it's going to be second and goal upcoming. All right, second and goal here for the Rockets. Two split left are Needham and Grady. Out right, looks like Evan Tice. It's a low snap again. He looks underneath, wide open, was paid, just floated out. I was going to say look for Patrick DeRoss. Patrick DeRoss was wide open, and the ball just led him a little bit too far. He got caught up in the wind a little bit too, Joe.
Yeah, the wind is whipping
right in our face right now, and I think that floated off of Troy's hands there. Third and goal upcoming. Hey, while we have a timeout here, Joe, get a little player profile. Number 72, Dave Swanee Swanson. His dad is a coach on the program, too. Great guy. Favorite food? Mac and cheese. Do you realize that Kraft mac and cheese has 22 varieties, Joe?
I only like the regular, Tim.
You know what? They actually call the regular, I heard officially on their website, is the only one you can officially call the cheesiest.
Okay.
Yeah. It's funny because I was thinking that some of your commentary last week would be right up there for the cheesiest. But how about they have one called Buffalo Cheddar? I could use that right now after my 24 hours straight in Manhattan. So his favorite male celebrity, Tom Brady. Favorite female? Don't have one.
Don't have one.
Who is he, Donald Trump? Huh. Oh, my gosh. So anyway, he wants to be an animal. Dog. Pretty boring. We're going to have to go. We have to dig deeper on these kids. All right, it's going to be third and goal here. Two split refs, three right. In motion is Damari. Troy's going to keep a big hole there. Troy cuts back, and I think he's in. Troy goes in. They spread out the offense, took three guys right, two left, have Damari just go right across, and Troy falls him in for the touchdown. Makes it look easy there.
Sees the hole well.
Early on with 6:35 in the first, the Rockets go up 6-0. We'll see if they're going to try a kick here. All right, Troy Pollock is going to be back. Damari's got the block. He's going to feel this, the snap. The wind's at his back here. Big rush, and Troy just kicks it low right into the back of the guy. So it's going to be a no on the conversion, and the Rockets lead 6-0. Getting back to Swanee, if he could have a superpower, flying. It's a pretty good one, huh, Joe?
Give him the ball, let him fly.
I'd love to fly. I'd love to fly right home from Methuen right now and watch the Patriots game. If the A-team had a team song get me pumped up, classic, We Will Rock You by Queen, right? Swanee is just bringing it today. They blew a whistle here. They're going to try it again.
I think he
was offsides. I think there was some guys on offsides here. So Troy's going to get another shot at it here. High snap. He pulls it down. He kicks it. It actually had the height, but he just pulled it. So the Rockets don't convert after the second opportunity. And with 6:35 to go, it's Reading 6, Methuen 0. Getting back to Swanee. Place he'd like to visit? France.
That's not bad. Paris, some wine, some cheese.
Have you been there?
I've never been to Paris or to France.
We already talked about you and cheese earlier, Joe. Right. We don't have to keep piling it on. But how about Kraft macaroni and cheese? My father, I'm no lie, one time when they sold it, and it was at that time it was 25 cents a box. He bought 100 boxes and put them in our house. We have eight kids.
Still have some?
I'm going to tell you this.
Let's go home now. First
time in my entire life, I don't even know if this is possible, that you could get sick of macaroni and cheese. And guess what? I still wasn't sick of it. I love that stuff. All right, so the Rockets are going to kick off here up 6-0. Man, this weather this late in the season, Joe, we're lucking out much better than last week where it was pouring on the kids out in Westford. Stevie Needham back to kick. Right down the middle here. He's fielded well. He's just going to pounce on it. Good move right there. So we're going to see Methuen's offense for the first time take over from their own 35. All right, here we go. Let's see that big Rocket D line that's been excellent all year long. See what they could do against the big line there of Methuen, too. So boys wearing the pink to commemorate Breast Cancer Month here in October. Hand off right. He's got a little room. He cuts back, and DiCrescenzo's in on him. Let's see who was low. Troy Pollock went low, and Dom DiCrescenzo went high. So it's a gain of about two. We'll say second and eight coming up. All right, call it second and actually really no gain there. So second and 10 here on the line. We got Fleming back on there. O'Connor, DeCrescenzo's over the middle. He backs off now. Lorenzo, Kajander out there on the outside as well. It's a handoff up the middle. He's got a little bit of room there to a Dom. DeCrescenzo moves in, and so does Patrick DeRoss. Nice gang tackling in there from Sean Beckenhuis. You know, we talked about this before the game. One of the things about the Rockets, they're not the biggest Patriot team out there, but they are a very, very good tackling team, and they're a very good gang tackling team, too. So
aggressive, and they hit. And
One guy gets a hand on you, Joe, there's going to be two other guys helping right behind them.
Just slow them down, and you got help.
All right, call it third and six, about seven right here, Joe. Third and seven, big play here from their side of the field. Oh, they shift up the lineup. This looks like it could be potential pass territory in motion. He hands it off to number 12. He gets met immediately and crushed. I think that's Needham.
There's that speed, aggressive defense.
Stevie Needham absolutely tattooed that guy. Fooled nobody, pushed him back 2 yards here. Now it's going to be fourth down, and this is a tough call here from their own 35. You may see them want to just gain some field position and kick it out. Yeah, he is back to kick here. Troy Pollock is back for the Rockets. Lone guy back. Yeah, Conroy split out left to try to prevent against the fake here. And he does boot it. Nice kick. Beautiful kick. See where the bounce goes. Troy's going to let that thing go. Oh, boy. He actually picks it up, and he's got room. Oh, my gosh. He's going to see him. And Pollock turns absolutely nothing into a huge gain. He's still on his feet. He doesn't want to go down. Oh, he's bouncing. He's going to go in. Oh, my gosh. What a play. It looked like he's going to let that thing go. Troy picks it up, scoots left. You know how fast he is. This is what happens. They see Pollock's speed for the first time. They don't know what to do with it. He's already passed him. He cuts in, cuts out left, and runs right down the seam, doing a high wire act on the tightrope, and he runs it for his second touchdown of the first quarter here.
He just has such good instincts. I mean, the coaches don't want him picking that ball up.
I'm going to tell you this. I saw his older brother, Ryan, play at Reading, and I know he went on to play at Tufts. He looks just like a mini version of him. He goes, not the biggest guy in the world, very, very tough runners. And Troy Pollock has been a star for this team all year, and he's actually one of the lighter guys on the whole team. You know, he could sneak behind a couple of our linemen. You can't see him until he's 10 yards down the field. Right now it's going to be 12-0, and it looks like the Rockets may go for one here.
He must have stepped out of bounds to see the scores.
Okay, six. Well, I thought they're going for an extra point here. They looks like he may have stepped out around the 5-yard line. So we're jumping up and down right here. Still a great play. First and goal here, though. Oh, it's going to be a keeper right underneath. And oh, he just out of the arms of Damari. Beautifully set up play there. And it looked good from here. It's just a little bit far right. Hey, thank goodness Danielle Beckenhuis is here paying attention, because we are sitting here just pumping up our extra score,
so
giving the wrong.
What you're saying.
Yeah, Joe, you're supposed to be my guy over here. Danielle is looking up at us, goes, yeah, they didn't score, guys. Why don't you guys pay attention? Stop blabbing on here. So it's actually 6-0 here. It's going to be second and goal for the Rockets. Second and goal here for the Rockets. Split way right is Conroy. Also Damari. Left is DeCrescenzo and Tice. Lucas Fleming is flanking Pollock in the backfield. It's a high snap. He's going to step up, and he throws it back to Fleming, and Fleming's going to take it. He dives in. Oh, he just steps out about. Oh, he gives him it. Gives him the touchdown here. Looks like he stepped out around the one, but we'll take that touchdown. Hands in the air. Nice looking play. I don't know if that play was actually a lateral from here. It's hard to tell if he threw it backwards, but nonetheless, turns into a pass and catch for Fleming from Pollock. And see, we just needed to wait a little bit. Danielle's all over us. You know what? They're very demanding fans there, but we're also maybe the most knowledgeable, right? They are actually looking at us with laser eyes right now, the fans. They have high expectations for us,
well,
Joe,
I don't
right?
Them. I mean,
well, we bring our A game every game.
This is big time, Tim.
I'm still a little foggy from being up for 36 straight hours, but that's okay, Danielle.
Come on.
Just relax there. And here we go. Pollock's going to try here for a kick. See if we can get two. Nice kick there, and he pulls it again. Troy making good contact, just pulling. He's definitely got the distance and the height going, and he's just pulled it twice. So we just waited an extra minute, Joe, before we get back to it. The Rockets with 3:38 left to go in the first quarter are 12, Methuen nothing. Hey, number 41 is Sean Beckenhues. His mother over here giving us some grief. I say grief, but she's just very knowledgeable. So Sean's favorite food, meatballs. Mm-hmm. His nickname, Shawnee.
Shawnee.
That sounds like a mother's nickname, isn't it, Shawnee? But speaking of that, though, he says this is election year. If you could pick anyone to be president, who would you pick? His mom. Hmm. Huh? Danielle Beckenhues for president, as far as Sean's concerned. Sean picked you. She's right next to be president. So I'll go for that. It's a nice kickoff right here. Yeah, she's working. Oh, my gosh, the ball's still live there. It's still live. Wow, the Rockets are very fortunate for Methuen to pounce on that ball. Getting back to Sean's favorite male celebrity, Tom Hardy. He's a great actor. Remember him? He's in The Drop with that Dennis Lehane right there.
He's in
a couple of good. He's also, unfortunately, I just saw Child 44. I read that book. It was awesome. That movie was brutal. That might have been one of Tom Hardy's worst. Favorite female celebrity? Kate Upton, right? Okay. I better keep my voice down here. Once Paul DeRoss hears that, he's going to want to move closer to us, start talking about Kate Upton again.
He did turn around.
If he could be an animal, say be a gorilla. Little known fact about gorillas, Joe. Like we have unique fingerprints as humans, gorillas, unique nose prints.
Oh.
Yeah. You can actually pick out which gorilla is putting his nose against your glass. You know, if he's inside your car or something like that, you know. So it looks like there's going to be a timeout here in the field. The Rockets up 12-0. Methuen's going to give their second offensive run in a little bit. All right, first and 10 here for Methuen from the 35. That's where they started the last one. Hold new D in there. There goes Pat Dwyer to cover his guy, Joe. It's going to be a keeper left. He's got a little bit of room, and he bites. Wow, nice play. And there's Sean Beckenhues right there to knock him out. So nice job on the keeper. It was sort of a counter play there, and he takes it for a first down. And Methuen Roosevelt, nice run by the Methuen quarterback. Here we go. It's going to be actually, it looks like he ran out of bounds earlier, so it's going to be second and three.
Playing a little hurry up, Tim.
Yeah, they want to keep these Rocket D off things. He throws them. He's beautifully throwing pass. And just a little bit too far. Man, that was a tight spiral he threw there. And it looks like number 51 was the Worm Musto on him on coverage.
G.
And Carlo Musto. Musto or Musto?
Musto.
If you can get it, I'm going to say whatever you say is the exact opposite.
Yeah,
so I call him Musto. But what a name, G. And Carlo Musto. That's like a name right out of the movies. All right, it's going to be third and call it three right now for Methuen. He's back to pass. He's going to swing it out. Nice play right there with Sean Cronin, 64. Oh, he turns it into something, though. Sean Cronin jumped right in the middle of that pass, blew up the play, but credit Methuen's quarterback. He actually turned it into a first down, got around him. But Cronin made a beautiful play to bust through and actually disrupt that play. And, you know, sometimes an athlete will make a play even on a broken one. We've seen Troy Pollack do it all year long. And their counterpart, number 11, does it now. Joe, I'm having a tough day here in the early going because it looks like he stepped out of bounds. He didn't look like he stepped out of bounds in front of us.
It didn't look like it to me.
He looked like he made a great play, but they say he stepped out of bounds. Fourth down here, and this is inside Methuen territory. They look like they are going to throw here. Three guys split left, one behind. Trying to position him, the quarterback now. Big play here on fourth down. Oh, someone jumps here, and that's going to be the Rockets, I think. Unless they moved. If they moved and made them jump, it is against Methuen. Now it's going to be fourth and seven, and they may rethink this pass altogether.
Thinking about the punt, Tim.
I think you're right on this one, Joe, so we'll come back in a sec. All right, fourth and now seven. You may see these guys decide to punt this thing, but down 12-0, they look like they might be going for it, too. So this is a huge play. In motion, number 16. It's going to be a keeper. He's going to follow the big guy. Oh, great job. He's going to be holding against Sean Beckenhuis. Not against him, but on him. And I think this thing's coming back, too. Beckenhuis had a bead on him, and they pulled him right down in front of him. They make it a big gainer, which would have been a first down, but it's always a first down when you rip down one of the best defensive players on the field,
that's
right?
That's why you got the first down.
And there you go. Now this thing's going to be fourth and 15. You're going to have to see Methuen kick here. Penalty hurts Methuen here because if they were going to go for it a couple times on fourth down here where they needed just a couple, but now they need fourth and 20. So look for him to punt here. Pollock is back. We saw what he did with the last one. Took it all the way down to the two. We yelled for the touchdown, of course. We were incorrect. Oh, it's blocked. Wow, who's in there? That's number nine
ball.
Is Jake Kajander.
Doesn't matter, just...
Oh, my gosh. What a play by Kajander. Comes in from the outside and blocks it. Beautiful play by Jay, and he has been a force defensively all year long for these guys. So Kajander gets in there. Nice job, blocks it. This is brutal for our friends up in Methuen here because we have excellent field position, already up 12-0 here, and the Rockets are going to take over deep in Methuen territory. Getting back to number 41, you got him? Sean Beckenhuis. Any place he'd like to visit in the world? Germany.
Ah, Oktoberfest.
If I could have a superpower, he says he'd have super strength. I think he already has it.
I was going to say.
Relatively speaking, he has
else.
It. First thing, it goes right to Sean. So Sean takes it. Oh, he's more than happy to absolutely run over their linebacker. Talk about super strength right there. His team song by 50 Cent, When It Rains, It Pours. And right now it is raining on Methuen right now. It reported on us last week,
that's
too,
right.
Didn't it? But it looks like it's going to be second and call it five right here after the run by Beckenhuis. Kajander in there, quarterback now. Kajander and Beckenhuis in the backfield. In motion, there he is, Pat Dwyer.
The flash.
The flash Dwyer. It's a keeper for Kajander. Oh, Jay Kajander does exactly what Sean Beckenhuis does. Lowers his shoulder and puts the pain on the linebacker from Methuen.
You're not going to want to hit him
there. Hey, listen, don't cut left or right, guys, on these holes. He used to soon run them right over. So we see both Beckenhuis and Kajander lower the shoulder on a couple of linebackers. It's going to be third and three upcoming. Okay, third and three here, deep in Methuen territory. Kajander and Beckenhuis in the backfield. Pat Dwyer, he was in motion more times last week than...
The marathon man.
That's right. Oh, it's a keeper for Jay. He's very, very close to the first down. It might be a... Let's see if they give it to him. It looks like it's going to be fourth down. It's fourth down. Obviously, they're going to go for it. It's about fourth and a foot. They swap out the entire offense right here. Nice job by that offensive unit. And with fourth and one, you may see a keeper here to Damari or Pollock, but look out for number 73 right there is Patrick DeRoss. He was wide open earlier today.
Yeah.
And he has been a star on this team this year, Pat DeRoss. He's got another year to go, too.
He does. I didn't know that.
How about that? Right up to Damari, cuts it back, and it looks like he's in. Nice job for Danny. Danny takes it left and right. We called it. Hey, we called the right one this time. Damari or... But Pollock to take it. Damari takes it off tackle. Cuts back for the touchdown. Makes it look easy, actually, Joe, to be honest with you. And it's 8:23 here in the half. And the Rockets are up 18-0. We're going to see if Troy and Damari can get a kick down here, make it work. Let's get some of the girls here over here from Methuen, the cheerleaders. Stop for one second. All right, here we go. It's a kick, and he pulls it again. He's got the heat. He's got the height. He's got the heat. I don't know what I'm doing, Joe. All right, but the Rockets, we missed some conversions, but, you know, all pretty decent practice here for Troy to get some kicks going. I'm very happy to have the Rocket cheerleaders with us up in Methuen here, Joe. Let's see if we can coax them to do a cheer for us. Rocket girls, I think they're just warming up out here. Just doing a little gymnastics here. We're going to come back to the girls. You know what? Maybe what we can do, Joe, is go down and say hi to them. Oh, look at this girl coming up here. She's doing 9,000 flips in a row.
I think I got hurt just watching it.
I'm telling you right now, my back is hurting watching that thing. All right, nice job. All right, looks like we get number 20. Foxy's going to kick for us. Brendan Fox, another first-year player. He's got some good fire. Nice kick by Foxy. It's a live ball there. He just pounces on it, number 5, and they're going to take over with their best field position today, the 36, not the 35. So we switch sides here. Methuen's going to see if they can get something going. They sort of snake-bit themselves with some penalties. But they do get some athletes back there,
yeah,
Joe.
Yeah, they did have that one good run, Tim, and if he didn't step out of bounds, they had a little something going.
I think so. We'll see what Methuen has in the bag of tricks here in the second quarter. First and 10 here for Methuen. Three guys split right, one left. Looking for him to come in motion, and he does. It's a snap. He's going to go back and pass. Oh, that was Lynchy in there. Busts up the play. One guy to get past. Nice job by number 5. He's got a lot of room ahead of him. Jonathan Grady gets in there, finally gets him, and so does Evan Tice. But a beautiful play. We just talked about this. They get some skill position players, and that's the biggest play from scrimmage right here for Methuen. And they are now going to take over first and 10 from the Rocket 35. Number 10, David Lynch, got in the backfield. Did a beautiful job of disrupting the play. And credit Methuen's number 5 for turning it into something. And a big play for him. First and 10 here for Methuen. In motion, number 20. Direct snap. He's going to follow these guys. He's got some room ahead of him. Nice job right there is number 14, Grady. So Jonathan Grady, I tell you, he had a beautiful block last week. He made a nice tackle there, and he makes another one to drive him out here. So Grady's getting some nice plays on defense here, but it's going to be probably a gain of about 7 right there. It's going to be, call it 2nd and 3. All right, they're speeding up the offense here. Not even going into a huddle. They want to wear down this Rocket D. He's in motion, inside handoff. Oh, he gets pushed back, but he's got a lot of room ahead of him, and two guys on Redding run into each other, and he steps outside. So unfortunate for the Rockets. I think it might have been Musto and Tice ran into each other pursuing, and they fell down. Huge opening as a result. He runs it for a first down. It's going to be first and goal for Methuen upcoming. Okay. Well, they keep the... No huddle going here. Want to keep this Rocket D on there. Make no substitutions. They do a quick substitution. Deemer for Lynchy. Tackle him, tackle him. It's going to be a keeper here. He gets spread outside. Looks like he got his hands on it. Wow, this Grady cuts over, and he looks like he gets in. Let's see. No, they looks like they pushed him out around the 1 foot line. And that was big pursuit by Grady over there. I didn't see who else. I think it was number 52, Mason Dion, in there as well. So it's going to be second and goal upcoming. Oh. All right, looks like we have called. I don't know if there's a timeout here. The referee is just stretching out right now. He must have, looks like he was on a train with me for 24 hours. All right, in motion, number 20. Oh, it's a counter right there. Beautiful play. It's not fooled anybody, and that's Deemer. How about that? They substitute Adam Deemer in there, and he's not fooled on the counter play. He came right in, and Foxy came in to help out too. So nice play by Deemer, and Foxy actually pushes him back. And now it's third and goal from, it looks like, the 5-yard line. By third and 5 here for Methuen. They took a timeout. They want to call a play or two here because they need to make this one happen. Oh, the ball is fumbled back there. Oh, and in comes Foxy. I don't know who got it. Did Foxy get it? He actually went a little bit too far, but I think it's possible the Methuen guy got it back. Foxy right in there on the fumble, pushes him back.
They got it back, Tim.
Wow, that's a fortunate bounce for Methuen. And they're going to go right back into the huddle here. This is a 4th down play. So they obviously called 2. They didn't convert on the hike there. It's another hike. Pat, number 5, looks like he's going to, oh, gosh, they trip over each other again. And nice play by Mason Dion over there. And that's going to be a beautiful play. They're going to turn it over on downs. Wow, credit the Rocket D there. Big pursuit. He did get around the side. Dion grabbed onto him, and he got some help on the back there. I'm not sure who the other guy, the defensive back, might have been Grady over there. And the Rockets are going to take over 1st and 10 from their own 5-yard line with a great defensive stop there. Unless they're staying, they look like they're staying on there. Did they call the third one a no play?
I don't know,
Tim. I don't think they could have because they actually moved that ball back.
No, it looks like we
That's right. Hey, listen, we're not that wrong here. Please, I think we got our offense in there, and we get the first down. So Rockets, beautiful play right there by the Rocket D.
Mason
Jonathan
Dion.
Grady, Joe Gilligan in there, right? Evan Tyson there. Dion did very, very well. He's been he's been great this year, Joe.
Really
Mason
has,
Dion
too.
Has been, you know, we talked about some guys who are really putting their stamp on him this year, and he's one of them. I got to call him a scientist.
The scientist.
Mason Dion, huh?
Just call him Einstein.
How about that? Einstein Dion was tremendous.
Einstein Dion, I like it.
It's a keeper right there. He's hit immediately. Oh, my gosh, and Fleming doesn't want to go down. So he gives himself a little bit of breathing room. Fleming got cracked and rolled right off it like it was nothing. But, yeah, how about Einstein Dion? He was one of my favorite player profiles, just dropping names of astrophysicists and cosmologists. Guys.
Stuff I can't pronounce.
He's a throwback, Joe. Throwback to when science was important. Okay, here we go. It's going to be a penalty here, and it looks like, is that an unsportsmanlike? On the Rockets. That's an odd one, and an odd time to throw it, too. Now they're doing it on Methuen.
Might have been a little tussle in there, Tim.
These guys are they're like us, Joe. He just pointed at the Rockets. Now he points to Methuen, and it's going to be a penalty. And we'll see if they mark a ball off here, if these things are offsetting. Oh, and it's Kajander in the backfield. I think he's with Kajander and Fleming. And so right to Fleming. He follows Kajander. Nice job following the block of Foxy. And that springs him for another few yards. So nice job by Lucas to move and let his blockers do work in front of him. So good block by Foxy, good block by Kajander, and he takes it for about five. I could switch up the offense. They go back to the Pollock-Damari set. It's going to be Troy keeping it just off tackling. He's got room, and he's not going to get caught. At number 11 is their best player. If he can catch him, I think Troy can just keep going. He's going to beat him. Nice job by Troy, and he gets in for the touchdown. He's trying to say, did he step out beforehand? And we'll say, we've been wrong before. And he calls it a touchdown. Wow. Beautiful play by Pollock. At number 11 is clearly Methuen's fastest guy, and he still couldn't catch him.
Yeah, and he had a good angle on him, too.
He had a very good angle, but you know what? You see Troy look back and do a little juke. One stutter step makes a guy take a step, and that's it. That's all you need to make it. So Troy, it's the Troy Pollock show here offensively early. Is that number three for him?
Who's keeping the stats? He's got to be
I know Damari's got one. I think he's got three. Ton of yards for Pollock, but how about that? Just a simple off tackle. He cuts it back and runs it. Wow, I'm going to say 70 yards for a touchdown by Pollock.
That's a 98-yard drive.
Here's the funny thing about Pollock. He's such a competitor. He's probably more mad that he's missed three kicks than he has got three touchdowns. And he's going to try it again. Let's see if we can get the point right here. The girl's imploring us. He boots it, and this one's right down the middle. Beautiful kick by Troy. I told you, that's the happiest play he's going to have all day. He's used to scoring touchdowns. But you know what?
That's his first one, his first kick conversion.
I think that's our first conversion of the entire year. And you know what? You need that. You need those kicks, especially when it comes to playoff time, because they're worth 2 points at this level. So great job there by Pollock. And listen, it's 24-0 here coming up on the half. You're going to see the Rockets start to call the dogs off here, maybe start running the clock. And I think this clock is off too, Joe. It says 5:39.
Yeah, it's a lot less than that.
Much less than that. We're going to be approaching the half here. The Rockets have this one in hand. And unfortunately, I think we sort of might have seen this one coming. So Rockets took care of this team last year. But you know what? Not getting ahead of ourselves, Joe, as Foxy gets set to kick here, is we're home for our next two. And those two are very big games, one against Billerica. And the next one against a Woburn team that's sort of a combined team.
I believe they're undefeated too, Woburn. So that'd be
great kick by Foxy. Up, good job right there. Number five wanted to turn that into a play, but his knee was down. So it's going to be 1st and 10 upcoming from Methuen from their own 30. But, hey, number 43 is Max Ramos, first-year player. Max is a good dude. He's in our carpool with
us,
Joe.
He's in our carpool, yeah.
Nice
kick.
Guy. Favorite food, steak. Oh, that's a man after my own heart. I could use one right now. Delicious. Favorite female celebrity? Scarlett Johansson. What do you think of that one, Joe?
Swedish.
Is she Swedish?
Well, it sounds it.
You have no idea who Scarlett Johansson is, do you?
I have no idea. I am a pop culture nitwit.
Well, I'll tell you what. This is what's crazy. She's an actress, right? She's beautiful.
Of course.
She's also a singer, if you can believe it. She did she did an album with Pete Yorn, who I really love, Pete Yorn. And, you know, it sort of hurts you when you see someone who's not only a great actress and is beautiful, then she has an unbelievable voice, too. So I'm going to give that as a little look up for anybody. Look up the album Relator with Scarlett Johansson and Pete Yorn. It's awesome, and she's totally great in it. It's going to be 1st and 10 here. We're going to get back to our Max shortly. He's back to pass. There goes Foxy in there. He just throws it away. Foxy Lynchy had big pursuit on him, and Sean Beckenhuis, you know, getting back to our boy Max Ramos. If he could be any animal, shark, right? He wants to go to Egypt. And once again, another guy who just wants to fly, right? Who else wanted to fly earlier?
He'd fly to Egypt.
He could fly to Egypt.
Fly to Egypt.
So Max Ramos, first-year player, and I love to see that. There's a bunch of guys who will actually start their football career right around this time, and it's really just to prepare themselves for high school next year. Here's the nice thing about the Rocket team is the Reading Pop Warner Patriot team does coordinate with the high school team. They use the same terminology. So that's pretty great that they use the same terminology for the boys who are going to move on and play in high school. But we talked about one kid who won't be going back and playing in high school next year is number 73, Pat DeRoss, is in 7th grade. He is going to be
an absolute force
next year for this team. And it looks like we have a little break in the action here. Here we go. Methuen is coming back out. Going to be 2nd and 10 here. They've had very, very little luck. Couple of big plays, but very little luck against the Rockets so far. Oh, high snap. Throws it underneath. Number one's open. Oh, he makes it. Oh, nice job right there by number 71, Patrick Dwyer. Great job by Patrick. He bounced it up in the air, and Pat came in and put a lick on him, and he couldn't hold on to it. That kid was going to make that catch too, Joe.
Yeah.
Pat Dwyer comes in and closes on him and makes a great defensive play.
I thought he'd be too tired at this point.
I know. He's raising his hand right now. Get me out of here. Get me out. Look at they might pull him out. No, it's going to switch up Dion and Grady right now. Too many guys on the field. They got to hurry up. All right, 3rd and 10 right here from Methuen, and they are putting themselves in a tough spot here inside the 20. You know, you're down 24-0 before the half. You have to go for it.
You have to.
You got to take some chances, but the Rocket defense is a little too much. They're probably breaking out some plays that weren't planning on breaking out. Grady and Tice talking about who's got who. Two split right, two split left, and now he calls a timeout. I don't think they had enough players on the side there. So timeout from Methuen. We'll come back shortly. Here we go. 3rd and 10 here. Actually, it's a lot more than that, isn't it? Oh, wow. Underneath. Beautiful pass thrown underneath, and great coverage right there. He doesn't want to go down, but 81 right there is
Zach Kenyon.
Is our boy Zach Kenyon. He wraps him up. Beautiful coverage right there, but a nice pass and catch, too, across the middle. They're going to need another one of those and a little bit more in this 4th down. You almost have to see them go for it down this many, Joe. Yeah. But this is where you're really playing with fire. If the Rockets get it back here, this game could be all season.
They've shown flashes, Tim. They really have shown some big playability.
You know what I'm hoping for? We heard earlier this year that they have a new offense installed here for the biggest dudes on the team. And when I say biggest, I may also mean slowest. He is going to kick it. One of those being a guy, oh, who's that back there? Nice play, Jonathan Grady back there fielding that. Nice job. Did a good job catching it. Good job by number 18 to hold him. A great field position. They have an offense called the McGilla Gorilla offense.
Is that Reading?
Yeah, Reading. They were going to put it in there, and if later in this game, we'd love to see it. You know who's part of that offense? Masuch. Deemer. Get him in there. Maybe we'll get Dwyer and Oki ball.
Yeah.
Huh?
Yeah.
Can you imagine those guys going off tackle? If they get any positive yardage, it's a personal victory for everybody. So the Rockets are going to take over here from their own 45, or from the Methuen 45, getting very close to the half here. Love to see that McGilla Gorilla offense going in there. Timeout. Well, our boy Odell Beckham just picked me up 19. We have Ramos, Cronin, big number 70, Pete Mirogiannis. I hope I get that one right. There's Masucci in the backfield. This is what we're talking about.
The McGillicuddy. Oh,
a little bit of movement. It was going to be, that was actually not number eight is Trevor Conroy. It was Conroy and Masucci in the backfield. Conroy dying to run with the ball. We had a little bit of movement on the side. It's going to move the ball back for the Rockets. They're going to go first and maybe 15, might be 20. All right, here we go. First and call at 15 right now. We got Masucci in the backfield with Trev Conroy. Split right is our boy, Pat Dwyer. It's going to be a keeper for Conroy. Nice play by number 11. That's one of the probably their best athlete on the team. Drops Conroy for a loss. You know, you get to a certain point, Joe, if we get up to 28, at this level, they make you run off tackle, which is a little bit boring for us. That's why we're talking about fantasy football up here, Joe.
Yeah.
You're pretty happy that you have Brandon Cooks going, and I got Drew Brees going right now. You know what?
I have Brees as well.
I made Good a huge team. Mistake last week, though. Because I actually put Lucas Fleming in my fantasy football lineup, and he was out his ankle. And I'm like, oh, what a mistake.
You didn't read the waiver wire.
He's been better than Mark Ingram all year, I'll tell you that. All right, here's the keeper right here. Oh, that one goes to Masucci. Masucci is going to follow Conroy, and Masucci gets wrapped up quickly. So there we are right there. The McGilla Gorilla goes to Masucci. He gets pushed back about a foot. I think. At some point right now, they're going to be calling number 71 and calling number 54. Pat Dwyer and Dan O'Connor need to get their hands on the ball. In goes Pollock right now as it's going to be third and very long. A couple of pushbacks with getting some new guys the ball in there, Joe. I'd like to see those guys get some positive yardage.
Well, Masucci's had a couple of nice runs in his career.
They got Masucci. Now they got Masucci split out right. How about right. this?
He's got to go in motion.
This is going to be fantastic.
There he goes.
I love it. Now you're saying he didn't even have to run right there. Masucci is already out of gas before the play's going. Here we go. It's a keeper. Oh, Troy is going to pull it down and throw it. And wide open is Pat Dwyer. Wow. Beautiful play by number 10. But Pat Dwyer had a step on him. And if Pat came down, well, that would have been awesome. Beautiful play by Pat. I like to see him throw it that way. So Pat's made a couple of nice plays here. Credit number 10. He stuck with him and made a good defensive play. That's a pretty nice throw by Troy. And Pat was in a great position. Wow, I tell you, Joe, if you didn't get Pat going out for that pass.
I'm not going home.
I think he may have missed that. We got Masucci in the backfield now with DiCrescenzo. Pat is split out right again. It's a direct to Dom, and he's going to try to follow Masucci. Masucci blocks and gets around. Dom takes it, but he's not going to get enough here. So on fourth down, they are going to turn it over on downs, but we have to be very close to the half here. This half is starting to really creep right now, Joe. Well, I think I'm ready to go home right now, aren't you?
Yeah, I am, yeah.
But it is starting to get the time is moving slowly right now with the Rockets. This one in command up here. It's actually a really beautiful complex up here, Joe, isn't it? Methuen did a great job. They put new turf
just
next door.
Just the last few years, yeah.
They put new turf at the stadium. And I heard they may be even putting some new turf on the old grass over there. So they got a beautiful complex here.
And they have good cheeseburgers, too.
Oh, yeah. My gosh. I needed a couple of that greasy food after my New York trip. This is what we dealt with this morning, Joe. I actually had to call you to give me a ride here. Yeah. I was so tired, I didn't trust myself driving. All right, here we go. Methuen's going to take over. They'd love to get on the board before the half here, make it a play. Rockets getting a lot of players in here right now. Look at defensive back Pat Dwyer. Dwyer and Grady back deep. In motion, it's high there. Number 11's gonna keep it. Good block there. This Tice running over. Oh, just misses him. Beautiful play. Evan Tice had a bead on him. He just missed him. Good athletic play to get around him. And there's Pat Dwyer who pushes him out. Number 71 and number 81 is Kenyon over there.
Yeah, 81 too. Kenyon's having a nice
Dwyer is stepping it up out here today, Joe. Oh my God, you're puffing your chest out like a peacock over here right now. Living vicariously through your son's exploits.
Hope his mother's here.
Great game for Pat so far. There's a whole half left to go. I'm going to see Pat get. Look at these guys. They're having a conversation in the middle of the play. He goes back to pass. Oh, big pursuit right there. He throws it up and over. Deemer was in with a bead on him. He had to get rid of it. So was Lynchy. I tell you, Lynchy's busting through the line on a regular basis here. Big number 10, so like to see that for Lynchy. And as we talked about before, sometimes it's not about getting in and making the play. It's just disrupting it.
Disrupt it in the head.
Lynchy high fives number 33. Joe Gilligan takes his spot. All right, it's going to be call it third and a maybe a yard here in motion number 16. It's a handoff to him. He's got plenty of room there. Wow, nice cutback there, and Grady wraps him up. That's a nice form tackle by Jonathan Grady, but it was a good block on Evan Tice there to spring him. So they're going to get a first down here, but these guys are telling him to hurry up because the clock is running. So no huddle here. The Rockets got to get ready. And he spikes the ball, and now we have, I'm going to call a penalty here. I don't think I have enough guys on the line.
Man, I just wanted to stop the clock, Tim.
They did. It's going to cost them 5 yards to stop it, which is fine, but they may, I don't know if we take any time off the clock this late in the half. Do they take a time off the clock for
a
defensive penalty?
I don't believe so.
I think they do on the pros, but not at this level.
Right. Even if they do, they'll have.
Oh, and that's it, though. How about that? They look like, oh, they blew it. These guys are running off, but Redding's staying out there. So Bethewitt's ready to run off of the half. And they do have a chance for another play.
This is likely the last play.
Credit the Rocket defense just for being disciplined here. The girls, the boys are setting up here because the girls are making a huge effort to come up to Methuen for us. Coach Pollock's got all the guys lined up here, and we're going to get to see one of their routines right here. I love it, Joe.
Yeah, we talk about the boys all the time. The girls work just as hard.
Well, you know what? A lot of times, sometimes they make it to the away game, sometimes they don't, and they are going to hear. So we'll take a look and watch. Yeah, great job there by the girls. I tell you, my favorite moment of that one, Coach Richie Marshall's daughter, Addison, doing a backflip almost into Troy Pollock's head. Did you see him?
He almost dove
out of the way. It was outstanding. Oh, my gosh, what a great play right there. I loved it. Listen, there's action even on the sidelines here. Nice job by the girls' team here, and they're going to go out and watch the Methuen squad right now. Here we go, Joe. Methuen ready to kick off here for the second half. He's going to go over to Dan Damari there. Picks up about the 23. Damari just runs it out of bounds right there. It's a little extra shove there, but 24-0 here for the Rockets. Jeez, it seems like the world's longest first half, Joe.
Yeah, it did seem like a long time.
A little bit of rain coming on us now, that type of thing. But you know what's nice in a game like this? Maybe we'll get to see some other guys get their hands on the ball, Joe. And that will be maybe have a little bit of fun here in the second half. Here we go. It's first and 10 here for the Rockets. We got Kajanda back there, and we get the meat back there. Wasabi Masushi. Goes to Masucci, follows Kajander. Masucci's got some positive ground on that one. Nice job by Masucci, takes it for about three or four, so the big guy rumbles off tackle behind Kajander and gains four. It's gonna be second down and call it, I say seven. I'll give it seven, not eight. Masucci's back there again. Direct snap to Kajanda. This time he follows Masuch. And I think that's Kajanda. It could be Conroy. 8 and 9 are tough to see. But that was Kajanda. So Kajanda takes it off behind Masuch, and they're going to switch it up. And in comes big Lucas Lorenza, the biggest guy on the team, next to the second biggest guy on the team, number 32, Dom DiCrescenzo. Couple of big bodies right there. Let's see these guys get the ball. I'd love to see Lucas get a ball here and try to run it off tackle. And he is in the backfield with DiCrescenzo right now.
That's a large backfield, too.
That is the largest one we can produce. Direct snap, it's a low one. He takes it. Nice job by Luke. He takes it for some positive yards. He gets about three or four. It's going to be fourth down here. But maybe fourth and three, we'll say. Maybe a long four, but fourth and three, and we got the big man in the backfield, DiCrescenzo and Lorenza. He set me straight in the off week, Joe. very upset with not getting his name called in the big tackle last
week.
What's
his favorite food? I think maybe you should deliver that to
him. Oh, my God. That's a direct one to Luke again, and he falls. He's got room. He's got the first down. He absolutely runs over their best player, number 11.
Oh, my goodness.
Number 11's the best player, the quarterback, and Lorenzo lowers his shoulder and crushes him.
Ouch.
And then takes it for another five. He may have to grab some oxygen right now, but that was a great play by Lucas. Oh, my gosh. What a great play he gets to midfield. Lucas Lorenzo runs off the field and gets mobbed by his teammates. Beautiful run. Adding insult to injury to number 11. Just gets. Oh, so this Masuch left. He gets stacked up very quickly this time. Need a little bit better push for the offensive line there, but Masuch takes it for maybe a loss of one. But what a great series for Lorenzo. He is pumped on the sidelines. And there goes Kajenda. Kajenda trying to pick him up. He did get him off about, he got him about a half an inch off. Now listen, one thing I wanted to talk about for the half, Joe, I was talking about Coach Marshall's daughter, Addison, who did a backflip. You actually thought Richie did a backflip.
I think I missed it, Tim. I should have gotten that on
camera. Did you miss that?
I think he did it. I honestly do.
Oh, my gosh. Well, listen, if we don't have it on camera, it could possibly have been Richie.
With all the phones,
he does have
the
moves. I've seen him on a dance floor. The guy can do it. He is fantastic. We get DeCrescenzo on the backfield now. It's a keeper left. Oh, he runs over two guys. Number one took a lick, and Dom DeCrescenzo takes it back to probably the original line of scrimmage here. It's going to be 3rd and 10 upcoming for the Rockets. All right, here we go. It's going to be 3rd and 10 here for the Rockets. We have DeCrescenzo in the backfield now. Oh, it's number. Oh, look at this play! And number 70 gets tossed over the middle to Pete Mirigiannis. Oh, my gosh, what a beautiful play there. They drop it like it's going to be an off tackle. He throws it over the middle, and big number 70 pulls it down. What a play. I love getting these other guys mixed in here. I hope I'm not butchering Pete's name.
No, I think that's it. I asked him earlier in the year if that's how he pronounced it.
They wanted to know. I think they were talking about calling him the Greek god. Was it the Greek god?
No.
I know what it was. The Greek freak is what they were calling
him.
Okay. I remember Oki asked him, is it okay if I call you the Greek freak? He goes, you bet it is.
Team of poets.
The Greek freak just made a great play right there. Freakishly good play. And this one, it's back to Lorenzo, and he goes off tackle. Oh, look at this. He's still on his feet. He doesn't want to go down, and guess what? He's got the first down. Oh, my gosh. Lucas Lorenzo refuses to go down. Looks like, there's a Methuen player hurt right now, probably one of the guys that Lorenzo steamrolled. They're going to give him a second or two to collect. But what a great play right there by Lorenzo. And before that, the Greek freak, Pete, was in there. And we'll come back in a sec. Hey, while we're waiting here, number 50 is Logan Fortuna. Another first-year player, I think, for us here, Joe. He's a big dude, too.
He's a big guy.
Favorite food? Chicken cutlet. Mm. I will tell you right now, I need a chicken cutlet right now. Mm. Immediately, I need one. How about this favorite male celebrity? Travis Pastrana. You know who he is?
No, another guy I've never heard
of. Supercross. Motocross. Sort of an X Games guy.
Yeah.
Ride the motorcycle. You're a motorcycle guy, right, Joe?
No.
Favorite female celebrity? Heidi Klum.
Okay.
Oh,
yeah, that's my generation.
Okay, here we go. Your generation.
Well, she's a lot younger than
me. She could be your granddaughter. Kidding me? Not your daughter. Heidi Klum. So Heidi Klum is
she's gotta be in her 40s.
I'm gonna tell you right now, Logan Fortuna just went way up in my book right now, picking Heidi Klum. Although you know what? I don't really like her when she's jibber jabbering a lot. You know, on the old show, what's the American Idol?
I turned the sound off, Tim.
Hey, you know what? There's no need to really hear anything about it. Who does she want to be president? Marshawn Lynch.
That makes complete sense
because he's a good interviewer, isn't he?
Yes,
Marshawn Lynch.
Yes.
Puts his helmet on, doesn't talk to anybody. He also wants to fly. That's three guys.
It's like the Air Force Academy.
Three guys today want to fly. Hey, look, as Logan comes off here while they're waiting for this guy to get a little help, right there we see Coach Marshall C right in front.
Right there. Now watch
and he's showing something. He's saying, look, girls, look at my flip. See my flip? I did my flip. I caught it on film. Backflip by Coach Marshall. So you know what? Maybe that's where his daughter Addison learned it. She learned all her moves. I know she's an Irish step dancer, and she's also obviously is athletic enough. Did an unbelievable flip, and she probably learned it from her father.
We're gonna poll the crowd, see who got it on their cell phone.
Oh my gosh! If you missed that one, Marshall is going to kill you. He's going to kill you.
He could just do it again.
You know what? I think we should do it. We're going to ask him. We're going to yell down to him. And here we go. Who do we get in the backfield for this one? Oh, we have Lynchy back there. Big Lynchy, number 10.
Rumbling bumbling.
I wonder who's back there with Lynchy. I can't see it. Oh, it's going to – let's see. Oh, he gets caught up. His 81 was Kenyon. Absolutely no push on the line there. So it was Kenyon and Lynchy. Lynchy took four. He took four like a bat out of heck up there, right?
He's going to block
running
somebody.
Right up the middle. He looked like he was running right for the end zone there. That might have been the same type of play they did with the Greek Freak, where Lynchy goes down the middle. But it's going to be pushed back here. Call it second and about 18 upcoming. There we go. We got Lynchy in the backfield again. I think that's Trev Conroy with him. Foxy split left, and it looks like the flash, Pat Dwyer out left. It's going to be a keeper for Trev. Oh, Trev does a nice job to cut inside, but it all over him there. Could probably use a little bit better push on our offensive line to give these guys a chance with who get the ball. Trev does a nice job to avoid the first one, but it's going to be third and long upcoming. Third and long from midfield. Joe, I'm about to start the Oki chance right here.
Okay.
I need to get big number 54 in there with the ball. Looks like DeCrescenzo and Lynch in the backfield again. Oh, he's way offsides, but he gets off. It's a low snap. They're going to call the offsides. The ball's fumbled
loose.
Right there. I don't know who gets the ball, but I think this is going to come back anyway. Whatstone was way offsides. He didn't get back in time. I thought at this stage you might see the refs just forget about it. He was going in the right direction at 24-0 here late in the game, but they're going to move this. They're going to reset the third down. It's going to be third and call it 12 upcoming. All right, here we go. It's third and call it, let's say, 15 right now. Lynch in the backfield again with DeCrescenzo. A couple of big boys there. It's probably the second biggest backfield. Dom takes it behind Lynch. He's still on his feet. He spins up. Dom is still on his feet. Oh, he rumbles that thing for about 12. He's going to be short of the first down, but it's going to be fourth and three here. And the Rockets clearly are going to go for it here. So who are they calling for? Should we start the Oki chant? Oh, they're Oki. Bringing in Big Lucas again.
Oh, you got to do that.
Listen.
He's your new fourth down back.
He's rumbled off one first down and a big run on the last one. They're going to give it, hand it off to number 24. And guess what? Every single person on Methuen knows it.
And
it's coming.
They're frightened. They're trembling.
They know what's coming, and they can do nothing about it.
Nothing.
The force that is Lukey Lorenza. Direct to Lorenza. Oh, he got. You know what? I'm going to say that Lorenza. I'm going to say that Lorenza was actually thrilled about that play because he got to hit someone hard and actually run over him. He didn't care if he didn't get the first down. Yeah, that was a beef collision right there. If we never say beef collision again, Joe, that won't be too soon, huh? But how about that? He was actually thrilled to just run into each other right there. You know, Lorenza right there takes it left.
I ran over this kid.
I ran over a bunch of kids. Great job for Lukey. Listen, for him giving me all this grief about being the biggest guy on the team, he still wants to be called Lukey.
Lukey.
Not Luke. I think that's a mom's name too, right? You're never going to argue with mom, so.
Never.
Great play by Lorenzo. There goes Jonathan Grady in there defensively. We got Pat Dwyer, the flash back there, number 71, way back. And we're going to see what Methuen can do upcoming. I want chicken cutlet. This is how riveting the game is right now. We're talking with Jill Damari about what are we going to eat for dinner.
What is for dinner, Jill? You're cooking
for us,
right? Oh, my
gosh. Jill, you have to cook for what, five guys your entire life?
Just put another 30.
Only three now. Yeah, the good news is they eat like a family of 12, the boys. You can imagine the grocery bill at the Damari house. Oh, it's outrageous. She's asking me what we're going to cook. I would love to get some chicken cutlet would be great, Jill.
Capri.
Have you seen Jill Damari cook? It's way better than Capri.
Oh, really? Well, I'm coming over.
Way better. Oh, wow. Number 11 stays on his feet. And he's still on his feet, but he gets pushed out at the very end by Tice. Good pursuit again by Jonathan Grady. He's another guy really stepping it up here. But let's get back to the most important thing here, what we're going to eat at the Damari's house tonight.
Starving.
How about, do you remember last year or a couple years ago, Dan Damari, we went down to the Gillette game. He was so happy that he had a couple of chicken cutlet meatball subs, and he called the rolls love pillows. They were so soft. They were so soft. He goes, I got to hit with these meatballs inside some love pillows. And I'm going to tell you this, if we never say meatballs inside of love pillows again, too, that will also be too soon. Beautiful pass right there down the middle, but number 20 gets stopped up. Grady back there again. And the clock is running and running at a snail's pace right here, Joe.
It may be the longest game.
Yeah, and unfortunately, you don't learn a lot about these games, too. You know, no, we knew that the Rockets were probably a stronger team. They are having a lot of fun. We're getting a lot of people in the in to touch the ball that normally don't get to do it, so that's fun. It's an inside handoff here. Beautiful play, Beckenhuis there. And here comes Grady again, and beautiful
tackle. By Grady.
Wow, you know what? That's a textbook tackle. He puts his head down to the side, wraps up his waist. That's the type of tackling, Joe, that they talk about heads-up tackling for Pop Warner themselves. And they you know, that's a perfect form tackle by Grady. And we've called his name a ton the last two games. Nice job. Number 14, too. That's one of my favorite numbers.
There wasn't much behind him. If he doesn't get him, it might be six.
Jonathan Grady playing very well. Inside handoff right there. Oh, boy. Number 43 was in there. Slowing him down was our boy Max Ramos. And then gets picked up by who? 71, Pat Dwyer. Ramos and Dwyer with a little bit of help from Beckenhuis.
Yeah,
right?
Beckenhuis, he put the finishing touches on.
Max Ramos got in there, number 43, wrapped him up down low, and in came the hammer, the flash. Pat Dwyer, the flash hammer. End around here. There is Grady again. He actually gets past him this time, but who was on there? Right in there is number 33, Joe Gilligan in there. Beautiful.
Joe Gilligan.
Awesome Joe Gilligan.
Awesome Joe. Yeah.
He's amazing, too.
He is amazing.
I think his father goes by amazing, and goes by awesome.
You're right.
So the Gilligan family represented well right here because we have Mary Dudley Gilligan here. Oh, my gosh. She looks fantastic. I wonder what they're going to eat for dinner tonight. I'm going to call down and see what the Gilligans are eating for dinner. All right, so it looks fine. All right, it's going to be first and 10 here for the Rockets. Who's in the backfield for this one? Could be right there. 41 is Beckenhuis. Wow, big hole for Sean. He takes it for rips it off about 9. Right behind the Greek freak, Pete. Number 70, big hole there. Ah, we're getting good here. We were just talking, I think Joe Gilligan is in the backfield
awesome
with DeCrescenzo. 32 and 33. Awesome Joe, a coach, amazing Joe, and the astonishing Mary. There's Joe Gilligan. Look
good
at the
space.
Thing. Oh, wow. If not for a great tackle, Joe Gilligan, first of all, he takes it for the first down. He had nothing but daylight ahead of him. The flash goes over and pats him on the shoulder. And then even better than all that with the Gilligan family, we heard that Mary's making chili today.
Chili. So I don't know. Do I go to the Gilligans or do I go to the Damari's for dinner today?
You know what we do? We go to the Gilligans for chili for an appetizer, and then we go to Damari's for chicken cutlets on Love Pillows.
On Love Pillows. Who's got the best beer, Tim?
I think number 52 is back there, Mason Dion. That kid has been awesome this year. We got Kajander back there as well. It goes to, oh, no, I think they had a miscommunication about who they're supposed to go to. I think it was supposed to go to Dion. Dion's dad is over here laughing. He's got a lollipop in his mouth right now. He's looking at Mason saying, yeah, I think that was supposed to be your ball. Einstein, Dion over there. Einstein almost had the ball. I think we're going to do the same thing again. Let's get Mason the ball on this one.
I think so. I'd like to see him run. He's had a great year in defense.
He has been awesome. You know what? We said this year there's been a lot of names we call him for the first time. We're doing a lot of great things. And who is in there now? I think it's DeCrescenzo in there. It's a direct snap to Adam Diemer, number 15. Look at Adam. Still on his feet. He doesn't want to go down. So there's our boy Diemer. We talked about Chris Diemer was up doing what was he doing? Oh, the article for you last week, right?
Yes, yes. And he was watching the Indians.
He's cheering for the Indians against the Red Sox. Is he out of his mind?
I don't know.
As Coach Masucci would say, are you out of your mind? And in comes Kajander and Beckenhuis for this round. All right, here we go. It's Kajander and Beckenhuis in the background. We get the flash hammer. Pat Dwyer split right. I need to see a pass right here. That's going to be Kajander keeping it. Oh, look at Jay. He doesn't want to go down. Very close to the first down. Jay rips it off here. The clock is running at 7 minutes. This is absolutely the world's longest game I've ever been a part of, Joe. It started an hour late.
Yeah, and it's just, I don't know what it is.
It's actually getting dark out here. It started raining on us in the backfield right now. Right now we got big. Finally, they heard our call. Big Dan O'Connor, number 54. DeCrescenzo, it goes to Oki. He's going to follow a guy, and he gets ripped down immediately. He's looking for who's he trying to follow there? I think it was Foxy, number 20. But Oki gets in there, gets a positive yardage. I think does he get the first down? They actually gave the first down to Kajander. I was going to try to pump up my son that he got a first down, even though he didn't really do it.
He got a second down, Tim.
He got a second down. That's great, Joe. He got a second down. Now he's over there holding his arm. He's out for the season right now, Joe, after that play. Who's in right now? It's a direct snap to number. Is that Sean Cronin? Oh, the ball's on the ground. No, it was Masuch was in there. And the ball is fumbled and picked up by Methuen. So Methuen gets the ball back on a fumble by the Rockets. Okay, first and 10 here for the Rockets. An hour and 10 minutes of tape. So far, this is 2 games ago, we did a game in 40 minutes, Joe. 3 guys split right, look for him to throw the ball. He does go back and he throws it up in the air. He sneaks on there. It looks like a different quarterback in there. It looks like Bethuen's going to mix it up and get some other players in here as well. Here we go. It's going to be second and 10 here for Bethuen. They're mixing up a couple of players themselves here, Joe, late in the game with the Rockets having in hand at 24-0. Oh, boy, in comes Lynchy and crushes him. So great job for Lynchy right there. You know what? He's been in the backfield all day, and he finally runs in there and tracks a guy down and gets his hands on him. And Lynchy rips him down for a massive loss. Great play by Lynchy right there, and he's had a great game all day. And he comes off right now, and he's asking for one of Jill Damari's chicken cutlet subs. Okay, it's going to be third and forever here with the big pushback by Lynch and the D. We got the Greek Freak out there. We got Max Ramos. We got Deemer. We got Gilligan. Oh, well, it's a little confusion in the backfield. The ball is fumbled. And, oh, who came in? Was that Beckenhuis? Beckenhuis comes in and crushes him. They fumble the ball. They're going in the opposite direction right now. And this might be the longest fourth down play I've ever seen. It's about fourth and 40 on this one, Joe. There's not how many plays do you have in the bag for fourth and 40 from your own five?
None.
I think absolutely none. This is when you see him air it out, though. Let's see it. Give him a shot. Oh. The fans watching this game, it's just excruciating, Joe, in between plays.
Sleeping over here, too.
He looks like he may actually be back to punt this thing. He just does just to get it out. Grady is back. Oh, too bad. I wanted to see Jonathan be able to pick that thing up. He does a smart thing by letting it go.
Out of the way, yeah.
But I would have loved to see Jonathan get his hands on the ball and try to do something there. So who do we get coming in here with Big Domi DeCrescenzo? Maybe we get the Worm in there, number 51.
Swanee.
Swanee's in there. We got Adam Noller in there, number 40, and he's going back. So we'll see what's going on and who gets the ball on this play. And 10 here for the Rockets, and we got Foxy in the backfield. Number 20, Brendan Fox. Let's see if he can follow Big Dom. It's a hike. He does follow Dom, and he does take it for a couple of yards. Nice tackle there. So Foxy gains 2. His hands on the ball, and we'll come up second down and 9. Second down and 9. Foxy back there again with Big Dom. This one goes to Dom, and he's going to follow Foxy. Dom takes it for 3 or 4 off tackle. Mercifully, the clock is running for us here, Joe. 3:29 and counting. Right back with Masucci. He was part of a fumble in that last one. He said, Coach, give me the ball again. I got to make up for it. The flashed wire down low. It's actually a keeper for Kajander. Oh, boy. Jay runs over the defensive backfield player, number 5. Oh, that one hurts. It's a first down. This one goes right to Kajander. He goes behind Masucci this time, rips it for a first down. And Jay is another guy. He would rather hit you than go around you. And he has run over a couple of people today. All right, first down here for the Rockets inside the 30. It's 2:20 and counting. Masucci and Kajander. This one goes to Masuch this time. And he rumbles forward for about two. So Anthony takes it up to the offside there, right behind Foxy and Jay. It's going to be 3rd and 8 coming up. And here we go. 2-minute warning upon us, and we got awesome Joe Gilligan on the backfield right now. Goes directly to Joe. He follows Jay. He gets around the end. Oh, just gets dragged down. So Joe had a little bit of room ahead of him. Nice play by number 88 to take him down. It's going to be 3rd and long upcoming. Okay, it's going to be 3rd and long. Joe Gilligan in the backfield again with Kajander. This one goes to Jay. He follows Joe. Jay gets around the end. He takes it for about 3 or 4. It's going to be 4th down upcoming, and the clock is just ready to run. I think they may just let this thing run out here, Joe, and we can wrap this game up. The Rockets are going to go to 6-0 here, undefeated on the season. Be very interesting to see what happened in that big Acton-Boxborough-Malden game. Those are guys that we may face in the playoffs.
Two good teams.
But upcoming, we have Billerica next week at home. The week after that is that Woburn-Burlington-Lexington hybrid team.
We're
very good. And so the next two games are going to be a lot more of a challenge, I think, for the Rockets. Pat DeRoss in the backfield right now. Goes direct to Pat. He's going to follow Kajander. Pat sees a hole, and he rips it up the middle. I think Pat may have the 1st down. Pat just probably said, give me the ball. He said, you know, he's gone all day without pulling a ball down today. He's been great the last few games. Keep him fresh up there. 34 seconds to go here.
That's a 1st down, Tim. I think you'll see one more play.
Yeah, you might see him kneel out here. But you know what? A crazy game. Sort of disjointed, Joe. Very long out here. But the Rockets had it in command early. Got to have a little bit of fun here. Got to see the girls do their routine. Got to see Richie Marshall do a backflip.
I still want to see that.
We're going to get that on film. And get to talk about a bunch more plays here. I think I may have talked about all the players who've sent me surveys, kids. So I might have to send it out. Get them all in here. The Rockets are going to win this one, guys, on a beautiful day here in Methuen. A late start, a long one. The Patriots game's over already. We won't tell Joe Gilligan what it is. He's taping it right now. But the Rockets line up in midfield. And great game, Joe. As usual, you brought your C game. So great to have you here, Joe. You were terrible. You missed a lot of plays.
I think I only missed my own son.
Yeah, anything your son did well, right. You missed on film.
I'll find out when he's 35 years old. That's why he hates me.
There's probably a whole host of reasons why I could hate you. But, hey, Joe, thanks a lot for coming out.
Too.
We're going to see you next week at Billerica.
At Reading.
No, at Reading. Against Billerica. Hey, you got something right. Good for you, Joe. That's how to end.